That's just why we're in the street, man, because the Bible's for everybody. So we're in the street because the Lord said, come in the street, lift up your voice like a trumpet.
Praise
show
more
people their transgression, man.
Praise more.
Show the house of Jacob their sins. So that's why we're in the street, and the Bible's for all of us. We're in Malachi. Ryan, give me Malachi, the second chapter. Pick that up, huh? Bible's for everybody. Everybody walk by here. They don't know what's going on. They look this way. Go ahead and walk inside the pub.
Come on through. Come through.
Sidewalk. It's for everybody to walk. Don't worry about the camera. You don't want to be on, go around. Outside that, this is free for everybody, man. The word is free. The Bible's here. You all got one. All you got to do is read it. Oh, man. Pick it up.
Malachi 2:1.
Right?
And now, all you priests, this commandment is for you.
All ye priests, this commandment is for you. All the priests, whoever call themselves a priest, whoever pick up a Bible and talk about they want to lead people and tell people what to do according to the Lord. All ye priests, this commandment is for you.
Read it. Malachi 2:2.
Right?
If you will not hear, and if you will not lay it to heart.
If you will not hear, and if you will not lay it to heart, to mind. Give me this Hebrews 4:12. Then give me Genesis 6:5 also. Because to lay it to heart, to lay it to your mind, is to consider it, to deeply consider what you're doing in the earth. Since you talk about you're a preacher. If you're a preacher, read it. Show what you got out.
Hebrews 4:12.
All right.
Take heed, brethren, lest it be any of you in each world. Hebrews 4:12.
Yes.
For the word of the Most High is quick and powerful.
The word, that's what we're reading here. The word of the Heavenly Father is quick and is powerful, you know.
And sharper than any two-edged sword.
And sharper than any two-edged sword. That's the word. The Heavenly Father, the Bible, is sharper than any two-edged sword. So we don't come out here with guns or weapons of war or stuff like that to assault people. To assault people, that's not how it goes. What do you think about the word of the Most High? It's quick and powerful. Read it again.
For the word of the Most High is quick and powerful. And sharper than any two-edged sword.
And sharper than any two-edged sword. That's the Heavenly Father, the word that the Heavenly Father put out, man. Read it on.
Piercing, even a divider, asunder of soul and spirit.
Piercing, even to divide your son. That's the Heavenly Father, the word. This word is going to break everybody's back, man. The Bible. That's why we're in the street to show you that, man. This word is big and bad. And nobody can't deny it, man. So we're on the block. In front of everybody, police, you, everybody, come see this action, man. Because the word is hot, man. The Lord's bringing it out like that. And it's quick, and it's powerful, and it's sharper than any two-edged sword. We don't need no guns, man. We don't need no guns to get up on your skin. Check this out. Read on.
Even to the divider, asunder of soul and spirit.
Soul and spirit.
Read it. And as a discerner of the joint. Excuse me. And excuse me.
Okay,
the word of the Most High is quick and powerful.
It's quick, man, and it's powerful. That's why this word can live in the street. Everybody got a Bible, but nobody don't read it. Everybody got a Bible, but nobody don't read it, man. And that's the problem. I want to go to Ecclesiastes 42nd chapter. Right? Read on.
And sharper than any two-edged sword.
It's sharper than any two-edged sword. That's this word, read it.
Piercing, even to the divided, asunder.
So this word is going to break everything and cut it in half. Piercing, even to the dividing asunder. Read on.
Of soul and spirit.
Soul and spirit. The word is going to break souls. It's going to break people's imaginations. It's going to break their spirit. It's going to break their desires and their all their will. This word is going to break them down. Read on.
Of the joint. And marrow.
It breaks bones. This word is hot, man. It breaks bones. Read on.
And as a discerner of the thought and intent of the heart.
Right, and as a discerner, this here, this word will break down the thoughts and intentions of your mind. Give me that Genesis 6:5. Show what you got.
Ecclesiastes 42:15.
All right.
I will now remember the works of the Lord.
Now we're going to remember the works of the Lord. That's why we're in the street. The Most High said, come out in the street, man. Showing up that word. Hoping that we know it.
I will now remember the works of the Lord.
We're going to remember the works of the Heavenly Father, man. Read it.
And declare the things that I have seen.
And we're going to declare all the things that we have seen. Come on.
In the words of the Lord are His works.
In the words of the Lord are His works, man. So you got to pay attention to the Bible. Read the Bible and understand life. And understand things breaks down. As we read before. out, Malachi?
Genesis 6:5.
Right.
And the Most High saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth.
The Most High said the wickedness of man is great in the earth, man. Everybody in the earth is evil, man. Everybody just practice wickedness, don't pay attention to this word. So he said, take it to the streets, man. Bring it out in the chief place of concourse. Give it to me. Proverbs, right? One. Show them what you got.
Genesis 6:5.
Right.
And the Most High saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth.
It's great in the earth, man. The evilness, the wickedness of man is great in the earth. Read on.
And that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart.
And every imagination. Every imagination of the thoughts of his heart. The heart is in your brain. The heart is in the midst of the body. The heart is in the brain. Read it.
With only evil continually.
With only evil. Continually. It was wicked. Continually. So the Most High said that's why he brought the flood down with Moses. And that's why he's going to bring the fire to America, to Babylon. Read on that.
Proverbs 1:20.
Yeah.
Wisdom cries without.
Wisdom cries without. That's where we're at. We're in the streets, man. Wisdom cries without.
She uttered her voice in the streets. She cries in the chief places of concourse.
She cries in the chief places of concourse. So we come downtown New Haven. Everybody pass through, and we blow out this word according to wisdom.
Read it. She cried in the chief places of concourse.
Right.
In the opening of the gate.
In the opening of the gates, man, where everybody come in. At the chief place of concourse. Read on.
In the city, she uttered her word.
In the city, she uttered her words, come
saying, how long, ye simple ones?
How long, ye simple ones?
When you love simplicity.
When you love simplicity, man. Everybody know the hypocrisy that goes on in America. They know the hypocrisy that goes on in their own life. How long will you simple ones love simplicity, man?
Read it.
And the scorners delight in their scorning.
And the scorners delight in scorning.
They love to scorn the Bible. They scorn the Lord. They say, we don't need that, man. We don't want that Bible. We don't need no word. They back up off that, man. And they go with some lies. They chase down lies. You understand? And they scorn the word. They scorn the truth.
Read on.
And fools hate knowledge.
And fools hate knowledge.
But that's who turned down knowledge. But fools, they hate knowledge, man. Bring it back to Malachi.
Malachi 2:2.
Read it.
If you are one, huh? Malachi 2:1. And now, O ye priests, this commandment is for you.
This commandment is for you. O ye priests, give me a 1:6, the same text, same book. Read it, 1:6. Give me a
Malachi 1:6. A son honors his father.
A son honors his father.
And a servant his master.
A servant, they honor his master. Read it.
If there not be a father, where is mine honor?
Where is mine honor?